I am such a fan of your work. I loved The Sympathizer so much. And then it wins the Pulitzer Prize. And I have to ask this. This is a book, obviously, that will become more popular after Pulitzer Prize. Do you ever see people reading it? Are you ever in public and you see someone holding your book? And what's that like?
I'm in L.A. I don't think people read books in L.A.
Oh, yeah, that's
true. That's part of the problem. But people tell me that they see them in the New York subway.
Yeah.
That's a thrill.
The New York subway, it's true. That is a still. And there's less and less. It's a little sad because, of course, with Kindles now, you can tell less what people are reading. But I guess if you're reading a Pulitzer Prize-winning novel, you want to have it in your lap, let everybody know how cool you are.
Show off, right?
Yeah.
But the other thing that happened is, like, The Refugees is in Costco now. And I'm totally stunned by that. People have been sending me pictures. I know I've made it when I made it to Costco.
Yeah. Yeah. I actually was at Costco. I bought 100 refugees, 100 copies.
That could be a literal statement, as a matter of fact. Right. Just refugees hanging around outside, and I bought a few, brought them home.
So this, you obviously, or not obviously, but for people who don't know, you were a refugee. Tell us a little bit about your story and coming from South Vietnam.
Yeah, well, I was 4 years old in 1975 when Saigon fell, and we came as refugees to the United States, settled in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania, at Fort Indiantown Gap, because refugees had to go through these resettlement centers. And I was at 4 years old, I didn't know what was going on. This is when my memory really begins. And my first memory is being taken away from my parents. Because in order to leave a refugee camp, you had to have a sponsor. So this very nice white family took me in. But at 4 years old, all I knew was that I was being taken away from my parents. And I remember crying and howling because of that, and I've never forgotten that experience.
And then you have a older brother and your parents, and you guys then were reunited.
Yeah.
And you move out to California. And is it true that you lied to your parents about what it was that you wanted to be when you grew up?
Well, I was an English major when I went to college. And you know how it is. Trying to convince people that you can make a living as an English major is really, really hard, much less telling it to your immigrant parents.
Yeah. So it is harder to tell your immigrant parents.
I believe it is harder to tell you when your parents are working 12 to 14 hours a day. And you say, you know what? I'm going to study the Romantic poets in college. And so I said, OK, I'm going to study the Romantic poets, but I'm going to be a lawyer. And that sort of held them off for about 4 years until I graduated. And I thought, well, you know what? I'm going to do a PhD in English, which didn't make them that much happier at all.
Did you, like, mumble English? I'm going to get a PhD in English.
Yeah. They heard doctorate, so I think I confused them for a little
bit. Doctor? And now tell me this. Does the Pulitzer, like, make up for it? Do they at least understand and have an appreciation for that?
You know, all I had to do was to make my dad happy was to win the Pulitzer. So that was a very low bar.
See, it's not hard.
Yeah, it's a really
it's
good
not hard
career
for
trajectory.
Immigrant kids to please their parents.
But you know what? Model minorities, Asian Americans, that's what we're supposed to do. We're supposed to win the Pulitzer Prize.
Exactly. I'm sure they went around the neighborhood and bragged it up.
You know, what happened was that when I won the Pulitzer Prize, I was traveling on the road, and I didn't even call my parents. Because I think at the back of my mind, I went back to my childhood. You're not supposed to go home and tell your parents you get A's. You only go home and tell them you get B's. So they can, you know, get upset at you. So
right.
I thought, Pulitzer Prize, big deal. I'm supposed to get this thing. You know?